What up, guys? My name is Aiden, and welcome back to yet another Fortnite Chapter 3 Season 2 video here on the channel. In this video, guys, we're going to be going over how you guys can fix your voice chat if it's not working here within this season. I'm going to be walking you through a step-by-step guide on how to go ahead and do this for every single console and every single platform that you can play Fortnite on for Fortnite Chapter 3 Season 2. So stay tuned. We got a lot to cover within this video. Real quick, if you guys would like any gift from the Fortnite item shop, make sure you're leaving a like on this video, sharing with some friends, subscribing if you guys are brand new, and finally commenting down your epic games. I do a daily gift giveaway in every single video, so make sure you're coming back for future vids. And with that being said, let's continue on with this video. So first things first, before you even go ahead and try any of the methods that I show you within this video, because they will be divided into specific chapters. I think we'll go over Xbox, PlayStation, Switch, and then PC to kind of wrap it up. Go ahead and check to see if your voice chat is turned on. Some people have been having issues with this because in the new season, for some reason, a lot of settings were changed. If your voice chat volume is below 50%, most people can't actually hear it. So make sure you have it at least above 50%. On top of that, go ahead and navigate to the voice chat section and check to see if you have any of these settings actually turned off. Fortnite has two different voice chat channels. They have game channel and then I have party channel. Basically, party channel is only going to allow you to hear the people within your current Fortnite party, and game channel is going to allow you to hear everyone within your game if you're playing like a team-based mode. And finally, the last little prerequisite is going to be heading into settings and navigating to your account settings and checking to see if you have parental controls turned on. Obviously, I'm 18. I don't have parental controls turned on, but you may have parental controls turned on, and if you do, go ahead and sign into that and tick off the button that says show mature language. Then you could just turn on voice chat and it should be working for you. Anyways, with all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into the first method, which is going to be Xbox troubleshooting to fix voice chat. Now, you may need to adjust your DNS settings. You can adjust your DNS settings, which may fix voice chat issues. In order to do this, you just have to press the Xbox button on your controller, go to the systems tab, then from there, head into settings, the network, then select networking settings, and then finally head into advanced settings. Once you're in advanced settings, go ahead and save the existing DNS servers on the screen by writing them down on a separate piece of paper or on your mobile device. If these changes don't work, you can actually change them back to your original DNS settings. Select DNS settings and then select manual. Enter the following new DNS servers. The primary DNS server is going to actually need to be 8.8.8.8, and the secondary DNS setting is actually going to be 8.8.4.4. Keep in mind that you'll need to enter both primary and secondary DNS settings or this will not work. If you're asked to set the MTU, enter 1473 and then go ahead and retry voice chat. If that still isn't working for you, set your privacy and online safety settings for cross-platform play. In order to do this, all you have to go ahead and do is head onto your Xbox, press the Xbox button to open the guide, then go into system and then go into settings and then account. From here, select privacy and online safety, head into the Xbox Live privacy, view the detailed and customized communication and multiplayer setting, and then head into family settings, manage family members, choose a family member, and then follow this next step. Now, this next step is actually just going to be choosing the settings for the following option. You can play with people from outside Xbox Live. This basically allows or prohibits all cross-network play. Click allow to use the voice chat. You can communicate outside of Xbox Live with voice chat and text. When you allow cross-network play, you can actually control who communicates with you. Choose everybody, block, or in-game friends. After you do that, you can retry voice chat again. Now, if that still isn't working for you, go ahead and actually clear your Xbox cache. If you don't know how to do this, you just have to press and hold the power button on the front of the Xbox until it turns off completely. Then essentially pull the power cable out of the back of the Xbox, press and hold the power button on the Xbox several times to expel any remaining power and clear the cache, and then leave the console unplugged for at least 30 seconds. After the 30 seconds are over, essentially plug the power cable back in and then turn the Xbox back on as you normally would. From here, you can attempt to use your voice chat feature one more time. If that still isn't working for you, then try enabling UPnP on your router. If you don't know how to do this, I recommend asking an adult or looking up a separate guide, because this guide isn't going to focus on it. Now, hopefully one of those actually worked for you. That being said, I'm going to move on to the PlayStation troubleshooting, which is actually a lot shorter. If your voice chat still isn't working on PlayStation, all you really have to do is actually adjust your DNS settings. If you don't know how to do this, you just have to go into settings, then network, then setup internet connection. From here, go ahead and choose your connection type. The options are actually Wi-Fi or LAN. LAN is way faster than Wi-Fi. From here, choose your custom setup. Choose the automatic IP address settings. Do not specify the DHCP host name for DNS settings. Select manual. Enter the following primary and secondary DNS. The primary DNS is going to be 8.8.8.8 and the secondary DNS is going to be 8.8.4.4. Choose test internet connection and make sure that you're still connected to the internet and then retry voice chat. Keep in mind that players on PlayStation 5 will actually experience voice chat interruptions when loading into Fortnite, but it should return after you successfully load into the game. That's all you have to do in order to fix your voice chat on PlayStation. Finally, we have Nintendo Switch, which is actually going to be the last console, and then we'll move on to PC troubleshooting. For Nintendo Switch, once again, it's just adjusting your DNS settings. You can adjust your DNS settings on Nintendo Switch, which could fix your voice chat issues by simply just going to the Switch main menu and then heading into settings, going into internet, going to internet settings, selecting your connection, and going into chain settings. From here, adjust the DNS settings to manual. Enter the following primary and secondary DNS. The primary DNS is going to be 8.8.8.8, and the secondary DNS is going to be 8.8.4.4. Make sure leaving the MTU settings alone, and then make sure that proxy settings are actually turned off. From there, you can actually retry voice chat. Finally, we have PC, which is actually what I'm on right now. There's a few different reasons why your voice chat might not be working on PC. The first thing is actually the Windows updates. Make sure that your Windows is actually fully updated. After that, you can actually head into your voice chat settings and basically make sure that you have chat enabled and check to see if you're using push to talk. If you're using push to talk, you just have to make sure that you're hitting that keybind before talking. If you're on Mac, you might have to adjust your microphone permissions, but that really is everything. But yeah, hopefully after doing all of that, your Fortnite voice chat for season 2 of chapter 3 is working. If you're having any other issues, it may just be your router. I would go ahead and restart that. But if you still are having issues, feel free to leave a comment down in the comment section below, and I'll try my best to go ahead and get to you guys and help you if you guys are still not getting this to work. I do want to try and help as many of you guys as possible, so I'm going to be checking the comments here on this video a ton. So just let me know if you guys need some help. That being said, before you leave this video, consider leaving a like on it, sharing with some friends, and of course subscribing if you guys are brand new for even more Fortnite Chapter 3 Season 2 content just like this, and I hope to see you in the next video. Peace. And for all of you guys who stuck around to the very end of the video, first of all, thank you very much. And second of all, I have a question directly for you guys. Would you guys be interested in seeing a Battle Pass giveaway here on this channel in the near future? I know I'm already a few days into Fortnite Chapter 3 Season 2, so I'm a little bit late on this. But if you are interested in a Battle Pass giveaway, feel free to let me know, because that's something that I would definitely be down to do here on this channel. I'd probably do like 5 winners and end it within like a week or so, just to give people enough time to go ahead and enter in it. But just let me know down in the comment section below if that's something that you would be interested in. One more time, thank you guys for sticking around to the very end of the video. I really do appreciate you guys, and I hope to see you in the video that I upload later today. Peace.